tonight's Play on One. Edna Doré and Bert Parnaby star as two pensioners striking back as they struggle to survive in a high-rise flat. In Jimmy McGovern's black comedy, Gas and Candles.
Nice day for it. It was freezing.
Could have rained.
She was in a coffin. She'd have kept dry.
Do you mind?
I want it as cold as that when I go.
We keep warm clapping.
I want a force 10 blowing. Hail, rain, wind, snow, everything. I want you all as miserable as sin when you put me in the ground.
You're getting cremated. Put that tie away.
I am not getting cremated.
You'll need it again.
Too bloody true, I'll be needing it again. Everyone we know, dropping like flies.
Had a few drinks, have we?
I'm on first name terms with the gravediggers.
Always the same. Few drinks, then it's Mr. Morbid.
I had two, that's all.
Two what? Gallons?
Pints. I am not getting cremated.
Set the table.
I want my 6 feet of earth and my marble slab.
You're a waste of space alive.
I am not getting cremated. One in a million gets a place in history. For the rest, it's a marble slab.
Being so cheerful keeps you going.
But I want that slab, Betty. Something to show I was here.
You've got a daughter and grandchildren.
Do
you think we need a water bottle?
What made him do a thing like that?
Tom?
Yeah.
He's your brother. You know what he's like. Oh, good night, love.
She's dead, Tom.
Cloudy but cool, and a chance of some showers. Maximum today, 15 degrees Celsius, 59 degrees Fahrenheit. Michael?
Ready!
A massive security operation gets underway today as our city centre plays host to the top of the cops, all of Britain's chief constable. Security is bound to intensify after London,
when the meeting will be addressed by the Home Secretary. We hope to have him in our studio round about 3 this afternoon, so if there are any points you would like to put to the Home Secretary, any questions, complaints
or criticisms, this is the number to ring.
Coming.
Yeah.
Why not?
Why not? I buried my sister-in-law yesterday.
Life goes on.
Ah.
What?
You've got a saying for everything, haven't you? Life goes on.
Well, life does go on.
Nice day for it. Could be worse. What will be. It all comes clean in the wash. Now it's the queerest folk. You never can tell. Who'd have thought it?
Listen.
Well, did you ever?
Listen. I could get angry too. Bitter, morbid and depressed. I'm old. Life's passed me by. Never going to be rich, never going to be famous. People ignore me. Or if they don't ignore me, they treat me like a child. But I don't let any of that get me down. Because if I let it get me down, I would just sit in here and rot. So I keep going, Bill. I accept it and I keep going. And if it wasn't for that, if it wasn't for me keeping going, we'd both be dead a long time now. Are you coming?
Musical chairs and bingo.
Takes your mind off things.
You're joking, aren't you? Every time I go, there's a 2 minute silence.
Could be worse, could be for you. Mind you, if it was for you, who could keep him laughing that long?
Ha ha.
Ha ha.
What about the cream?
It's on your list.
I'm not asking for pile cream.
Why not?
They'll think it's for me.
Well, it is for you.
I don't want the world and his wife to know, do I?
But when I ask for it, they think it's for me.
That's different.
How?
Because it isn't for you.
I'm sure there's logic there somewhere, but I can't quite see it.
It's only right that you ask. You are the cause of them.
How do you work that one out?
The doctor says they're caused by diet.
Then he's wrong.
He's a doctor.
He couldn't cure bacon. You sit on the lavatory all morning picking out the horses. That's what causes them.
If you're over 65, you join a queue. If you've managed to survive, you join a queue.
If you're over 65, just be grateful you're alive. If you're over 65, join a queue. When I was 65, I got the pass. I managed to survive and got the pass. But the driver called the journey, though he wasn't quite that good. He sure I shoved me past right up in the wrist. If you're over 65,
come so that I may treat you with insulting condescension.
Let's all go and burn the TPO. If you're over 65, you join a queue. If you've managed to survive, you join a queue. If you're over 65, just be grateful you're alive. If you're over 65, join a queue.
An employee of the DSS. You all come to me when you are in distress. To eat and to keep warm, dear sir, fill in a form and dry your eyes, I'm not easy to impress.
He's an employee of the DSS. We all go to him when we are in distress.
I'm not Santa Claus.
He's more like Rudolph. Yes, yes. If you're over 65, join a queue. If you're managed to survive, join a queue. If you're over 65, just be grateful you're alive. If you're over 65, join a queue. Yes.
Yes. Can I help you?
C-
condoms.
Have you any ointment for hemorrhoids?
Judy, any pale cream in the back?
Horrible things, aren't they?
What?
Piles. I've had six of kids, not piles. And after every one of them, agony. Like bunches of grapes.
I haven't got them. It's the wife.
Oh, then my heart bleeds for her. Of course, they do say it runs in families, whether it's true or not, I don't know. But my old granny, she suffered something chronic. She died at 96 with a fag in her mouth. I miss the corner shop, you know. People talked when they served you, and you could get a bit of tick. These days it's all barcodes and bleeps and girls chewing bubble gum. I can go weeks and not talk to a soul, you know. It's like people are trying to avoid you.
This is the number to ring. 071-246-8000. What do you think about the drug problem today? Are the police doing enough to stamp it out? Is the policy of our police correct? Or does it lead to an increase in drug abuse? And what about police operations in general? Is it time to get back to Bobby's... react quickly enough? Can charges of racism within the police force be sustained? Well, to tell the Home Secretary exactly what you think, ring this number now. 071-246-8000. An eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth. Should capital punishment be restored? Should it be restored for acts of terrorism? Or does this only produce martyrs for the cause? Tell the Home Secretary exactly what you think. Ring this number now. 071-246-8000. Are the prisons too soft? Are the police ineffective? Was it really that much better in the old days? Get your point of view across. Phone 071-246-8000 and put your questions to the Home Secretary now.
What's up? Where'd that come from?
Scotland.
Who do you think you are? Rockefeller?
I didn't buy it.
You must have done.
I didn't.
Something? You're expecting a funeral or something?
You never know your luck.
It happened.
I did not steal it.
Not on purpose.
You think I'm going senile or something?
Going senile?
I did not steal it. I never went near any salmon. God knows how it got into me bag, but I did not steal it. Please.
The murderers, or the bank robbers, or the muggers.
Every single flat. Two men to each, both armed. I want a mobile HQ right here, now.
Yes?
Police officers.
What do you want?
Well, can we come in?
It's a bit inconvenient right now.
Is your husband there with you?
Yes.
Well, can we speak to him?
At the moment.
Tied up?
For the moment.
When will he be free?
I've no idea.
Is there somebody in there with you?
No.
Then why can't we speak to him?
I've got to go now.
Get the super. He's in this one.
Please. No need to panic, just move along as quickly as you can. There's a gunman up above. Now get out! Come on!
I'm not calling you a robber.
Of course you are.
I am not. Betty, am I calling him a robber?
No.
Sounds like that to me.
He's not calling you anything, Bill.
We're going.
Don't be so stupid.
Do as you're told, woman. We're going.
Don't you dare speak to me like that.
Betty.
Don't you dare treat me like Betty. A piece of muck.
Betty.
Betty. Betty.
What do you want?
Would you like a phone? Engaged? She's on to Australia.
110 in the shade, eh? 110. Well, you use plenty of oil, Jean. Your skin can't take it. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I'm all right.
When are they coming over?
Oh, we couldn't. I mean, it's the other side of the world. We couldn't go all that way.
When are they coming here?
Well, perhaps one day, eh?
How can we afford to go over there?
Well, the six of them, how can they afford it? What? Oh, yeah. Yeah, your dad's all right. His pals are still bad, but that's all.
Oh, for God's sake, woman.
Yeah. Oh, yes. Hasn't he grown?
What? Put the receiver down.
Yes. Yes,
we can get
the photos.
Who else?
No one else.
Don't be afraid, Betty. He's not gonna hurt you. Who else is in there with you?
Mr. Sharp.
Mr. Sharp? What nationality?
Persian.
Bloody Arab.
Extraordinary that two quite unassuming old-age pensioners should be involved in an international crisis like this. But for Bill Johnson of Canterbury Heights and his wife Betty, this is exactly what has happened.
That's the thieving git who robbed my salmon.
What? I said, are you all right?
Yeah.
Is there anything you need?
No.
You sure?
Yeah.
Are you comfortable enough?
Well, not comfortable, no.
Has he hurt you?
Who?
Mr. Shah.
No.
Then what's wrong?
It's a bit personal.
Would you like a doctor?
Yeah.
Right. We'll send one up right away.
Didn't get the cream then.
They think you're a robber and they treat you like a lord.
It was on your list, powerful, top of your list.
I asked for it, didn't I?
Is perfectly clear.
Young girl made a show of me.
Lives in the
bawling it out all over the shop.
23 Canterbury Heights.
Loads of people in there and all.
An ex-railway.
Beam me up,
Scotty. Both pensioners, both are now being held hostage by a gunman who calls himself Mr. Shah. Mr. Shah, as he is now called, ran from his car, through the communal entrance, up the stairs, and got as far as the fifth floor. Whether Mr. and Mrs. Johnson allowed him in, or whether he overpowered them, we don't know. There were no witnesses. What we do know is that he is...
What are you doing?
They think we're being held hostage.
Let them think it.
Are you mad?
We've got a phone.
Are you absolutely
We're getting a doctor.
Mad?
They'll give us everything we ask for. There'll be reporters, the deli, everything.
But they think there's a terrorist in here, for God's sake.
So what? You can cremate me, Betty. You can do what you like. Because this is my marble slab.
Let go of me.
This is my bit of the limelight. This is where they find out I'm alive.
Oh, not.
What are you doing?
What do you think? Hello?
You'll do as I say.
I will not.
Oh, no. Of course you won't. You don't do things like that, do you? Not since I've retired. Not since I've stopped bringing in the money.
what?
It's true. I stopped bringing in the money, and that's it. Suddenly I haven't got a mind of my own. You're telling me to do this, do that, treating me like muck, like I was a little kid.
Right.
I'm only a bus driver, for God's sake. Well, good a matter now, terrorist. Let me go, will you? Please, lads, let me go. It's been a mistake, honest, it's been a mistake. What kind of a terrorist is this? They ask for a plane, don't they? This killer has asked for a bus. Why mine? Why does it have to be mine? Suppose the stand ever been as time to leave it. I've never even met a guy. Let me go, will you, please? Let me go!
Please don't shoot, please, don't shoot, please.
Do you know why you're here?
No, I'm no good to anyone.
You're telling me.
Well, let me go then, please. I've got a wife and kids.
You drive the number 32.
Yeah.
And you were supposed to be at Tunstall Road at 9:35. But you get there at 9:28, just so you can stop the pensioners getting on.
What's that going to do with the Ayatollahs?
They're pensioners too.
Concern did mount about 2 hours ago when Mr. Johnson asked for a doctor. Obviously, the feeling was he may have been injured by the terrorist or suffering from stress. But it transpired he wanted hemorrhoid ointment. Neighbours say Mr. Johnson has suffered from them for a number of years. The bus driver is still being debriefed, and it's doubtful whether he'll
I'll
be allowed to talk
them.
To newsmen until
He's
this
whole affair. He's told the whole world I've got pies.
Mrs. Can Johnson
shut
is...
Up.
No, I won't. He's broadcast it to the bloody nation. I want the Home Secretary. I want the Home Secretary and the boss man in the BBC.
Doesn't suffer, never has suffered, and never will suffer. From piles. Is that it?
Yeah.
On news at 10?
Yeah.
Put Mr. Sean.
I didn't mean it.
You did. It's got nothing to do with money. God knows when you did work your brought home shirt button. So it's got nothing to do with money.
I know.
You don't know. Do you remember our Jean and her arm?
Yeah.
That physiotherapist with a wart on her chin with air sprouting out of it. God, you could sew a button on with it. I hated her. She's telling our Jean to lift her arm up higher and she can't, and she's crying with the pain, and I'm near crying just watching her. But that physio's shouting, higher, higher. I hated her. I struck that air out and strangled her with it, and she knew it. But it worked. Jean lifted her arm.
Yeah?
You went to work for 50 years and then all of a sudden nothing. All your routine gone. What do? Lie in bed all morning? Highlight of the week if there's racing on the telly? Not while I'm around, Bill. I keep you going. I give you your routine. I'm your physio bloody therapist and I get up your nose the way Wartface got up mine.
I didn't mean it.
Seen too many men retire and die in a year.
Why am I doing this? We want some food.
Put Mr. Shaw on.
He won't come to the phone.
He wants food for the three of us. Roast beef and Yorkshire pudding.
A typical Arab meal.
He fancies a change.
If he lets one of you go, we'll send in some food.
He says no deal.
No food.
Back to potatoes.
One. 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 One.
She didn't eat.
I can't see the milkman coming somehow. He's petrified of next door's dog, never mind a terrorist. I'll make a meat and potato pie. That'll keep us going for a few days. There'll have to be beans with everything. Oh.
Hello?
And it's staying off until Mr. Shah speaks to us.
Early night, then.
Neighbours.
Oh, no. We'll miss it.
Not neighbours, the neighbours. The man on the telly said they knew all about my piles.
Yeah?
Well, how did they know?
I don't know.
You told them.
I didn't.
You must have done.
I didn't.
You're always going on about things like that, you and the bloody neighbours.
We don't talk about things down there. Mary Roach's husband's got a swollen testicle.
He's calling me a robber.
He's not.
I'm not.
Scrounging, that's what you said.
I said the world doesn't owe us a living.
This country does. We gave up the best years of our life for this bloody country.
Oh, for God's sake.
We fought for this bloody country.
We had to fight.
Then right through the 30s we went treated like muck.
It was the same the world
over.
Now
it's all happening again. And you were saying they're doing a good job.
They are. The country needed a kick up the arse. People had to learn to stand on their own two feet, the young and the old. Look, why should I expect others to help me out? Eh? They're not my family. They don't owe me anything.
They've turned the water off.
It's staying off, Bill.
In that case, we want some food and a pot of tea.
No way.
There'll be bloodshed.
Has he made a threat?
Yeah.
Full alert.
What kind of threat?
We've got a cat and he's threatened to eat it.
Half my constituents keep cats.
Food in, cat out.
We need to make demands.
We made some.
Proper demands. Political demands. Best meal I ever tasted.
A live interview with the BBC. No deal.
Good night, love.
Night. I'm hungry again. Do you want the bad news?
Go on.
It's beans again. Do you want the good?
Yeah.
It's the last tin.
Minister, have you managed to contact Mr. Shah yet?
We haven't spoken to Mr. Shah, no. But that is irrelevant. This government does not make deals with terrorists.
Yes.
It's been a week now. What if you were in there, Minister, or your family?
Well, then, I would lack the necessary objectivity.
We've had no official statement from the police.
I'd love an ice lolly.
Minister, do you intend taking no action?
No, we are not in the business of starving pensioners to death. We have told Mr. Shah, if he lets one hostage go, we will send in some food.
I'm not going out without you!
Get you! You're going out that door, woman!
I am not! Don't you dare eat me!
Did I hurt you?
No. You okay?
You took a cob out of me.
I had a bit of an appetite. I've put up with you for 51 years. You and your piles. So why should I stop now?
If you go, they'll send in food and drink.
We go out together.
And they'll lock us up together.
Well, they'll do that anyway. The longer we stop here, the longer we'll get.
Then go.
Oh, no. Because I can just see you with your cronies. Oh, I'd have stuck it out forever, but she wouldn't have it. Okay, so I'm impressed. You've stuck it out longer than I thought. I mean, there's been World War III in here if I've been half hour late with your tea and toast, so yes, I'm impressed. But you're Bill Johnson of Canterbury Heights, not Lawrence of bloody Arabia. So why don't we pack it in now, eh?
I want to see them lose.
Who?
Them. Them out there, the winners. Them.
Is it Tom? It's Tom, isn't it?
Tom? Tom?
What?
Why did you do it?
Do what?
She's dead, Tom.
It were a choice we made. It was a choice we made. And that's what it's all about, you see. The power of choice. She looked after me, and when she couldn't look after me, I looked after her. Nobody else. No Meals on Wheels. No do-gooders. Nothing. We stood on his own 2 feet, lad. Why are you looking at me like that?
She's dead.
I got sick. My heart, you know, I got sick. And I couldn't lift her. She was too heavy for me. And I couldn't lift her. So, she had to lose weight. Can't lose weight if you eat. Why are you looking at me like that? All I've done is to stand on my own 2 feet. So why are you looking at me like that?
How's Mr. Shaw doing?
He's as strong as ever.
How?
He's got his own supply of food and he's making it last.
We'll be dead in a couple of days. He could last weeks.
Ask Mr. Shaw to come to the phone.
Who are you?
Ask Mr. Shaw to come to the phone.
He won't.
What does he want?
Food and drink.
Okay.
And a live interview with the BBC.
Okay.
And the telly on for a couple of hours tonight so we can watch Question Time.
Okay.
Tony Benn's on.
We send in some food. Give them an hour or two. And then we send in the troops. Tony Benn.
Who won't shut up during Question Time?
You.
I pass comments. It's meant to stimulate discussion.
Not during the programme.
Of course during the programme.
Look. If I want to know what you think, I can find out, can't I? I can find out any time I like. But I want to know what they think. And Question Time's only on for an hour and you keep rabbiting on all the way through it.
Don't go rabbiting on. I pass a few comments, that's all. And what about you, eh?
What about me?
You know quite well. Every time Neighbours comes on, you start. You start snoring as soon as it comes on, snoring your head off. You do it out of spite.
I don't do it out of spite.
You do, the minute it comes on. And it's wide awake again for the news.
The news is a bit different from Neighbours, isn't it? Question Time's a bit different from Neighbours, isn't it?
My one little bit of pleasure ruined by your snoring.
A load of rubbish.
Phone them.
What?
Phone them. Tell them we don't want the telly on at all.
Don't be so soft.
I'd keep quiet. They didn't have so many old fogies on.
We've got soldiers all over the world. And do you think I give a bugger about that when we're frightened to open our own front doors?
You can't say that.
What?
Bugger.
Why not?
It's the BBC.
I'll say what I like.
They'll censor it.
It's live. Do you think I lose sleep over the Falklands getting invaded? No. It's here I'm worried about, my friends. Somebody coming into my house. 23B Canterbury Heights. Never mind the other end of the world. So,
Let's have the money spent here. Never mind the fiddlers and people like that. They don't bother me. But the housebreakers do. Item two.
10 minutes. 10 minutes.
Bye-bye.
Very good activity, and this has been going on for some time now, and it indicates an initiative of some sort.
Exactly what? I cannot say. But I do know that the police have still not spoken to the gunman, so this rules out a negotiated settlement. Force does seem the only solution. But I must stress that's only conjecture at this stage.
They abolish the earnings rule, and I'm supposed to be grateful. 50 years hard labour, and I'm supposed to say thanks very much for a few more. Well, I've got news for them. I don't want to work. That's what retirement means. You don't work anymore.
Hello.
So, we need a decent pension. One you can live on, that's what we need, not work. What is it?
There's nothing to be frightened of, Betty. Just see if you can turn the radio on, nice and loud.
You're going to come bursting in, aren't you?
No, 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 I promise you, Betty. We just want the radio on, nice and loud.
We can't.
Why not?
You've cut the electric off.
Frightened?
I'm frightened of everything, Bill. I'm frightened you'll get hurt, or worse. I want us to grow old together. Cottage in the country. Ivy up the wall.
Nobody up there, I'm telling you. I was evacuated by the special branch.
Yeah, sure you were, Paddy. Yeah.
Have you found a weapon?
Yep.
The fourth floor of a place in Tithe Barn Street. Right?
Right.
A self-assembly 7.62 millimeter rifle with a telescopic sight. Bullet right. With a mercury tip. Right. There's nobody up there, you clown.
Did you take that?
Yeah.
Wipe it.
Here we go, here we go.
of pensioners heading our way. All units go.
Human life is precious, yes, but so are peace and stability. And peace and stability are threatened when you bow to the demands of terrorists. So I stand by my decision, gentlemen. That is all.
Minister! Minister!
Shut it, woman!
We need to talk.
As far as the press is concerned, Mr. Shah was cut down in a hail of bullets. His body carried out in a coffin. Now, that's a nice, neat little story, and we wouldn't want you to spoil it.
And if we do?
You have aided and abetted a terrorist. You have wasted police time and resources on a massive scale. You have endangered the lives of policemen and soldiers. You have caused an international incident. We have got four aircraft carriers steaming up the Persian Gulf thanks to you. You'll get about 25 years each.
And if we say nothing? Okay.
Well, that's very sensible. If you don't mind me saying.
No.
What?
No. You ought to be ashamed of yourself. You're gonna pack it in now. After all we've been through, you're gonna pack it in now. Well, I'm not. A day or two ago, maybe, but not now, Bill. He was going to make speeches, big political speeches, peeing into the wind. It's all he's ever done all his life. But I'll make one. I'm 72. Life's taught me a few things, and one of them is this. Your weakness is your strength. I'm old, one foot in the grave, and I'm skint. That's my weakness. That's why people treat me like muck. But I'm old. So why should I be frightened of 25 years? 30, 50, 100. I could be dead tomorrow. And I'm skint. So why should I be frightened of going to prison? Feed me, clothe me, keep me warm, which is a damn sight more than you do for me outside. I'm old. I'm foot in the grave. I'm skint. I'm not frightened of anyone.
Betty. Bill. What would you like to do most in this world?
Australia.
They say it's good for piles.
What?
Sunshine.
Salmon, please.
There'll be bluebirds over the white cliffs of Dover tomorrow, just you wait and see. There'll be love and laughter and peace ever after tomorrow when the world is free. The shepherd will tell